Today's lesson is about animated charts in Excel and how a simple VBA code can help us to achieve this kind of charts. If this sounds complicated to you, don't worry, we will go step by step. We use VBA to control the animation. Here we've got our source data, and here we've got our dynamic source data, and you'll notice that this is formula based, which I will explain later. This dynamic source data fits the chart that we will create in a while. Also, we have a control cell that dictates what is displayed in these columns I, J, and K. In these columns, we've got an if formula, and it's deciding which data is displaying based on this value in control cell. Let's look at the formula. It uses the row function. The row function simply returns the row number that is inside the brackets. If that is blank, it returns the row number that the formula is in. We are in I3 cell, so it will return the number 3 as a row. If you highlight only the function and press F9, you will see the result, which is 3. This is a nice trick to see a part of the result of a large formula. So the formula says, if the value in E3 is greater or equal than the current row, then display the value in A3. And if not, then return #NA. Remember, #NA don't display in charts. The control cell has a value of 3, so it returns the value in A3, which is 52. If I change the value to 10, then it will display the values from I3 to I10. As the control cell counts up, more and more of this data here is slowly revealed, and that is how we create the animation of the chart. To complete the animated chart, we need two steps. The first step is to create the chart, and the second step is to create a VBA code that changes the value of the control cell from number 3 to number 38. Finally, with the help of a button, we will execute the VBA and the chart will start to animate. Let's start from the first step to create a cluster column chart based on this data and presented them in a particular format for each time period in different color. Here we have a column for each year, 2017, 2018, and 2019. The January in the second year is repeated in the previous column and the same in the third year. This gives us a continuation of the chart without any gaps. So, highlight the data table from G2 to K38. Click on Insert tab and select the clustered column chart. Move it somewhere there. Change the value to 38 so it will appear all the columns. I will use formatting to give the illusion of one chart instead of three and give a continuous look. Right-click any of these series, format data series, and increase the overlap percentage to 100%. Also decrease the percentage of gap width to 50%. Delete the legend, the grid lines, and the title. The chart is ready. Now it's time for the VBA. First, Developer tab, Macros. Name the new macro Animate. And make sure that the macro is in this workbook. Press Create and it opens the Visual Basic Editor. Now I will paste the code and explain it. Save it and make sure that you save it as XLSM type, which means macro enabled workbook. Let's take a look at the VBA. We strongly recommend to use Option Explicit at the start of your Excel VBA code. Using Option Explicit forces you to declare all your variables. Sleep is a window function and not a VBA function, but you can still use this function in VBA code by calling the Windows Sleep API. Actually, sleep is a function present inside Windows DLL files, so before using them, you have to declare the name of API above the code in your module. The syntax of sleep statement is as follows. Here, a delay specifies the time in milliseconds, till which you have to pause the execution. The advantage of sleep statement over wait is that it is quite flexible, as you can give the time delays in milliseconds, while in wait function you can only delay the application by whole seconds. Here is the name of the macro. If you change the name in the VBA editor, you need to reassign your macro to the button you are using to run the macro. Use the dim statement at the module or procedure level to declare the data type of a variable. For example, the following statement declares a variable as an integer. This is the number range you want the macro to scroll through. These are the numbers in your control cell. This is the worksheet name you want to control on, which is sheet 1. And this is the cell you want your control entered in. Finally, this controls the speed. The lower the number, the faster the chart scrolls. Okay, that's how the VBA works and how to update specific parts like worksheet names and so on. I want to assign my macro to a button. Go to Insert tab, Online Pictures, find the play button, like this, put it somewhere here, and with right click, assign the macro. Now, every time I hit that button, the macro runs and the animation of the chart is starting. So that's how you can do an animated chart. I hope you enjoyed the lesson. If you like it, give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't done so already, so that you can get updates when I put out new videos here. I want to thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video tutorial.